I think everyone's probably had lifting corners once or twice. I recently printed this card wallet and it had a little lifting on one of the corners, but why do prints do that? It's one of those things you get different answers because different things could fix the problem. Let's go through a few things that you can check or do with your prints that can help with this. What's this guy got to do with it? So real quick, why does it do it and why is everyone's fixing forums to make an enclosure or check for a draft? Basically, if you think about it, the print's just not holding strong enough to the bed in a particular spot. When the next hot layer is laid down on the cold layer below, it does its thing, it shrinks the tiniest amount, and that shrinking pulls up on the cooler layer that's already shrunk. A weakly held spot, typically a corner where the forces of two lines concentrate, are more susceptible to then pulling off the bed. You get the problem more printing with high temperature filaments like ABS, nylon, PETG, where the temperature difference is higher between what's already been printed and the new plastic that's going down. So basically, people suggest an enclosure or ask if there's drafts because any kind of a breeze blowing on the print can cool down the print that's already done faster and it makes the problem worse. But what's an easier fix? First thing I do is clean the bed. Some isopropyl alcohol and a lint-free cloth does wonders. Remember, your printer is full of parts with lubricant and oil, so anything you might brush against while you're getting prints out could put those things on the bed. And they have the specific purpose of making things not stick. Even natural oils on your fingers can do the same thing, so make sure you keep your bed clean. Next for the easy things is think about increasing the temperature of your bed. No, not for a nap. It keeps what's on the bed warmer longer, so the new layer temperature differential is less and they cool together, reducing the stress. Let's talk fans. If you think again why it's happening, turning off the fans can help let those layers cool slower. As the layers are put down on top of the last, the temp difference is less, so this can help the layers cool down together. That reduces the stress that's pulling up on your print. You could also look at rafts, or my preference, brims. A raft is a lot thicker, and I lifted the corner here on purpose to force it to lift and show that with the height of the raft, even if it lifts, it can protect the corners a little bit from deforming as much as it would without. It extends out from the print as well, so it gives more hold on the bed, but my preference is a brim. It doesn't raise the print at all, it just extends out the perimeter for extra hold. Rafts interface with the whole bottom layer of the print, so you don't get as clean a removal unless you really dial in the settings, and I don't bother because of my preference being a brim. Typically it comes off much easier than a raft. If you really need to, it can be cleaned up with a craft knife or deburring tool really quickly. I'll talk about a variation of the brim, the mouse ears, in a minute. A lot of brands are coming out with enclosures for their printers. You can buy or build one if you don't have one already. If you're regularly printing high temperature filaments, it's a good investment of time and money. Be sure to think about ventilation though. You don't want anything catching fire. Next, if your bed heater is like mine and it's not quite as hot on the outer edges of the bed, you can try some corner tabs, or some people call them mouse ears. They're basically a brim that can be placed just on the problem areas. In CURA, there's a plugin called Tab Plus you can install, which makes it super easy. You can make a couple of selections and you can add them automatically. I like to put them in manually because automatically tends to add more than I would typically need. PrusaSlicer and clones like OrcaSlicer, I haven't found a better way to do it, but you can add objects to the existing print right in the slicer. Just add a cylinder, adjust the size, and I make it a multiple of the layer height. So in this case, a 0.12 layer height, I make the cylinder 0.24 for two layers thick. Then you can set your X and Y. I normally do 5 to 10 millimeters. Then you place them so that they're just touching the edge of what's lifting, normally right in the corner. It can sometimes be tricky to make sure that it's touching, so I normally just go through the first layers. You can also get fancy and put them out from the edge and just have a tiny strip going back to the corner to help with removing. but they come off normally with your fingernail, and you can trim them if you need to with a deburring tool or a craft knife. If you like this video, check out the playlist link showing all the trending prints for the last few months that we've printed and show how they go together. I'll see you next time.